Now, what I want to ask about today is a really important employment issue. 2 weeks ago, Equifax, one of the big three consumer credit reporting agencies, announced that they'd been hacked, jeopardizing personal information for about 143 million Americans. Americans are outraged by this hack, and let's face it, they have every right to be. There is a lot at stake here. Identity theft can follow you literally for the rest of your life, particularly the theft of your Social Security number and your birthday. And it gets worse. Your credit history can affect your ability to get a loan, to buy a car, and even whether or not you can get a new job. According to a survey by the Society for Human Resource Management, about 50% of employers in America check the credit histories of prospective hires. Now, Ms. Dillon, you are President Trump's nominee to serve as chair of the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, the independent federal agency that enforces civil rights laws prohibiting workplace discrimination. Do you think employees should compete on the merits of the job or on whether or not they already have enough money to pay their bills?
Well, thank you, Senator Warren, for your question and also for your time last week. I appreciated it, where we discussed this issue.
Yes. No surprises.
You know, as we discussed, currently the FTC has jurisdiction for enforcing FCRA. And with respect to the current structure of employment law, really, I think the remedies are limited to whether or not, if an employer decides to have credit checks as part of its hiring process, it does so in a non-discriminatory fashion. But the issues that you raise, I think, are very interesting issues. And I would like to look at the data. I think we agreed we're both data geeks. And also, I would look forward to working with you on this issue because I think that the issue you raise is an important one.
So if we can, let's talk just a little bit about the data because this is a good chance to get it out there and have people think about this. You know, there are a number of problems with employers using credit histories in their decisions for hiring and promoting people. First, neither job performance nor worker productivity is correlated with credit history. And second, credit histories are riddled with mistakes. The recent Equifax breach will make those mistakes even more likely. According to a 2012 study by the Federal Trade Commission, more than a quarter of Americans sampled had an error in their credit report already. And these errors are really hard to correct. I don't know if you've ever tried to correct one, but they are a bear to try to fix. A follow-up study by the FTC found that a majority of their sample who had reported an error on one of their credit reports still believed that some part of their credit report was inaccurate. There's one more problem, though, with using credit histories to screen job applicants. Credit reports may look objective, but they have a disproportionate impact on people of color. For example, blacks are more likely than their white counterparts to have no credit history at all. And those who do have a credit history, on average, have lower credit scores than whites. There's even evidence in a new working paper from researchers at the University of Wisconsin and Harvard University showing that employers penalize black applicants with bad credit more than identical white applicants with bad credit. The unemployment rate already for black Americans is twice that of white Americans, and we should be finding ways to close the gap, not to help the gap get wider. So, Ms. Dillon, if you are confirmed to the EEOC, you'll have plenty of ability to bring claims against employers whose use of this policy is having a disparate impact on groups protected by Title VII of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, including workers of color. So I just want to know if you will commit to doing that.
Well, Senator, as we discussed, if I were confirmed, I would want to work with the career professional staff. I would want to review the data, the data that you cited, whatever data they may already have collected that I am not privy to completely understand the issue. And I look forward to working with you to address the issue.
Okay, and I take it that what that answer means is you'll look at the data. If the data back up these claims, then you're ready to move.
Then we're ready to work on solutions, absolutely.
Okay, thank you very much. You know, this the magnitude of this Equifax problem is just almost impossible to comprehend. One small thing that Congress can do to make life a little easier for people who are affected by this hack is to pass a bill. I've got a bill going forward now to say that employers cannot use this information in the decision to about who to hire and who not to hire. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate the time.